Prepare to be amazed. What if I told you if you could click together the foundation of your .NET MAUI application, including a beautiful design, all the view models wired up in an MVVM way, all the themes, all the styles, all the code for the custom controls that are being used, localization, right to left support. Well, I'm sorry, I kept going on and on for there for a little minute. I hope you got all of that. But this video is going to be all about that. I've been talking to the great team behind Grial Kit. You might still remember them from the early days in Xamarin Forms, where they were already doing great designs as well. And they made the thing Gorilla Player, which is like the OG XAML hot reload, if you still remember that. Doesn't really matter. They are back with a new major version of Grial Kit, and they have done something spectacular. So full disclosure, this is not a sponsored video. I'm not getting anything from them. They invited me for a little call to celebrate their new release, their new major release of Grial Kit 4, which has some amazing things that you're going to see in this video. And I got so pumped because it looks amazing that I decided to do a video about it. The only thing that they kind of gave me is a license, because it's a paid product, a license, so that I can actually show you all the goodness here today, so that you know what you're actually getting whenever you decide to purchase a Grial Kit license. And you might want to stay tuned. Maybe I have a couple of licenses to give away by the end of this video. I've already mentioned they have been working since Xamarin Forms and the early days, and they've been doing amazing designs. I'll be honest, I thought that they were drawing a lot. So they were doing a lot with Skia Sharp and they were drawing controls. Turns out that's not the case. They're doing basically everything except for the charts, I think, with plain XAML and plain stuff that's inside of the box for Xamarin Forms and now .NET MAUI. So what you're about to see is both available for Xamarin Forms. In fact, the most complete set is now for Xamarin Forms. .NET MAUI, they're implementing that as they're going. A lot is already there and more is coming each week, but some designs are not available yet in .NET MAUI. And they don't stop there. They have a maps control. They have a video player. They have a bottom drawer. They have all kinds of crazy stuff. I'll show you that in a little bit. But what I wanted to focus on more is that they have this crazy concept. I don't think they have a name for it, but I'm going to call it app in a box, app out of the box. I don't know. You can click together your application inside of their web portal. You can download a fully runnable, customizable solution, project, everything's in there that you can run and use as the foundation of your .NET MAUI application. Actually, let's just stop talking about it. I'm just going to show you what it's all about. So our journey starts at grialkit.com, which is their website, and they completely redid it for this new major version of Grial Kit. As it is with website, it might change a little bit over time, so don't worry if it looks a little bit different. But I love the opening statement that they have here. Build beautiful Xamarin Forms and .NET MAUI apps faster. And I really think faster is the keyword here, because they're making it so easy to bootstrap and kickstart your application with what you're about to see. If we scroll down here a little bit, you will get a glimpse of all the cool designs that they have in place here for all kinds of different purposes. We'll see that in a little bit. We can scroll down even further. Choose your content. That's an important one. We'll see that in a minute. And here you can customize everything. So they have design guides, style guides, everything in place that you can just use, but you can also customize it if you have a set of colors that you need to use for your brand or something like that. But one thing that I wanted to get at is here, scroll down, demo app available on the store. So right now, Grial Kit is available for iOS and Android on both Xamarin Forms and .NET MAUI. They're looking into the desktop platforms for .NET MAUI, because .NET MAUI, of course, has a renewed focus on the desktop platform. But for now, iOS and Android. And if you go out to the stores on those platforms, you can search for Grial Kit, download their applications, and you can play yourself with the designs that you can see here, the controls that they have for you, and you can show it to your friends, to your family, and whenever you decide that you like it, you can go out, buy a license, and use that inside of your own application. How crazy cool is that? So whenever you're finally done admiring their website, you can click this sign up button here in the top right, and it will bring you to some kind of admin portal. If you still need an account, sign up for it. If you already have one, scroll down here and it has a sign in button as well. I already have it, and it will bring you to this dashboard. If you're doing this for the first time, it will prompt you to create your first app, your first app definition. So each block that you see here is a separate app that you can download all the stuff from and you can keep up with. So you will always have that single app definition version at the least. I have two test and testing, and you can see one has the license attached to it. So I'm not going to go into the licensing right here. If that's something that you're interested in, go check it out. I'm sure it speaks for itself. If there's something that you can't figure out, let me know down in the comments and I will bring you in touch with the team so that you can figure it out. But this one has the license. So whenever you click into here, you will get to the dashboard for that app. And immediately you will get the page catalog, and you can see all the designs here. So we have something with articles. We have something with, I don't know, tiles. We have something with movies right here. A timeline. We have e-commerce, so you can see products. A product overview. We have a map with some kind of bottom sheet here at the bottom. You have all these crazy things. So you have a chat timeline. There is crazy beautiful designs in here. But if, as you can see, when I scroll here over the map one, it says not available in .NET MAUI. So not everything is available yet. And actually, when I started playing with this, I clicked a couple of pages, I downloaded the code, and some pages were missing. And I was wondering for a second why that was, because not everything is supported in .NET MAUI, but those are supported in Xamarin Forms. I brought that feedback to the team, and I think within a day, they implemented this filter for .NET MAUI pages. So whenever you click this here on the left side, you will now get the pages that are supported in .NET MAUI. The rest is still going to be implemented over time. I think they have monthly or weekly updates, so stay tuned. It will come for sure. So let's just click a couple of pages, shall we? Let's just go with this. I don't know, the article's feed looks pretty cool. Add page. You can see that it gets added here on the right. Then I also want the article details because I want to have the list and then the details. What else do I want to have? Maybe something with like an onboarding or something, a welcome, here we go, a welcome page, walkthrough image, and maybe some kind of about page. I'll just stick to four pages for now. So add those pages. You can save it here at the top so you can revisit later if that's what you want. And then here at the right, you will see all the selected pages. You can also say add all pages, so it will just add all the pages to the selected pages, or you can remove all here. And whenever you're done with selecting all the pages, you can go over to the left here and go to design. Now they have a couple of themes for you available already, light and dark, Capella dark and Capella light, Kubrick dark and Kubrick light. I think the creative minds over at Grial Kit are having a blast with all these designs. So you can select one that will be the default inside of your application, but you will still get all the themes anyway. So you can switch out later if that's what you want, select it at runtime if that's what you want, but you can select the default one here. You can also select a accent color. So right now it's blue, but if you're more of a red person, then you can select red or pink or yellow or whatever you want. You can see the preview is updating here, so that's really cool. And that will be selected in the code. So let me revert this. You can also upload your app icon if you have one already, and that will be inserted in your code ready to go as well. Whenever you're done here, go to the download page here on the left. You can configure your solution name, project name, all the things of your source code. You can already specify your Android package name, so the identifier for your store, iOS bundle name, and you can even change culture. So you can add different localization options here. You can add Afrikaans, you can add Arabic, you can add Dutch, you can add all the languages that you can imagine, 261. You can just add that and it will have translated resources for you inside of the application. So that is really cool. Then back here on the right again, you will see a preview of your solution. I think this needs a bit of updating because this is how a solution would look like on Xamarin Forms, not for .NET MAUI. But here, a little bit down, you will have for .NET MAUI, you can download the kickoff solution, which will have my four pages. Same thing for Xamarin Forms, a little bit lower, or you can download the full Grial solution, which will download all the pages, basically. And down here at the bottom, some license information. Again, it will be included in your download, so you can just do that. Now, I'm going to click the download kickoff solution here, and we'll get some more configuration options. So the Grial version, I think this is the latest one, so you probably want to also have that one, unless you have a really good reason not to. You can read more on the .NET MAUI version, and you can now download the solution. So if we do that, it's going to prepare the solution. So it's actually going to dynamically, generate everything from the source that we've clicked here, the colors, the pages that we selected. It's going to bundle that into a zip file, and we can download that and actually use that as running code as the basics for our application. So the compiling is ready. Before compiling the solution, you will have to configure this NuGet source in Visual Studio. I have a video on how to add NuGet sources to Visual Studio. It should pop up in your screen right now. Basically, you'll just have to add this URL and you need credentials to actually log in. So these credentials, you can set a separate set of credentials inside of your user profile. So click there if you want to do that. I would highly recommend that you do it. Enable NuGet dedicated user, set a username and password, which you can use to then authenticate to the NuGet feed. So whenever you add that NuGet feed and start restoring the NuGet packages, it will ask you for a username and password. Insert the username password that you configured and everything should be good to go. Then you can say, okay, download. So it's going to download that zip for me. That will be in my downloads folder. I'm going to unzip that, open that in Visual Studio, and I'll see you over there. So here I am in Visual Studio. I unzipped all the code. I opened it in Visual Studio, installed that separate NuGet feed and ran it on my Android emulator. And you can see it just works. Because I selected the articles feed as the first page, that is the first one that I'm going to see. But here in this flyout menu, you can see all the other pages as well. It has it all. And because the pages are not necessarily connected, it doesn't really know how to navigate from one to the other, right? So that's where they're all inside of this flyout menu, and you will have to connect the dots there. Although, this is one of the nice details that I really love about the Grial Kit team. The articles feed and the articles detail, they are connected, right? So if I go to this articles feed and I just scroll down here and I click this one by Ivy, it will bring me to the article detail. It will show me that same image, the title, it will have some text, it will show how many people visited this, how many people like this. It will have this nice markup for this quote right here. It did something about the author. It has three comments. You can click on that. The event is wired up. You can leave your own comment. Again, the event is wired up. So this is really cool. It already knows how to navigate from one to the other. So if you would click on all the pages for the e-commerce app, it's basically already working because the navigation is already set up for you as well. So that's even more dots connected that you don't have to worry about. So we have that. What other pages did we have? We have a walkthrough image, so kind of like your landing page for your app. I can scroll through here. I can click the next button to go to the next one. You will have this finish or the skip button right here that will take you right out of it. But you will have this nice onboarding experience for your app right built into this Grial Kit as well. While I'm here, this image right here will have that accent color that you selected in the portal. So this has the blue shade that I selected. If you selected something else, it will change as well. And this generic about page is an app, but really an app. If it doesn't have an about page, it is right here. So we have this about page as well. And that's beautifully designed, ready for you to use right here. So that's all the pages. But what's even more amazing than the designs and this running is the actual code. So let's dig into that. Here in the background, you can already see the app.xaml, and this has the merge dictionaries and basically all the things for your styles and dictionaries. You can see it's a long, long file with all kinds of styles in here. Also comments to help you get along with this, to help you be on your way. So it begins and the ends, and also comments to help you with like, watch out for this or that. So it's really helpful. You can see we have all these themes still here. So we have the Capella dark theme, light theme, Capella theme. Even if you didn't select them in the web portal, they will still be available in the code right here. You can find them here under the themes folder, and you can just enable one by commenting this one out, the my theme, commenting the other one in, and then you can start using that one. And you have all the XAML right here for all the themes, right? So you can open that, you can start tweaking this thing, and you can tweak all the themes in here. And the themes are then marginally built up from all the styles. So we have all the styles here, all the fonts, all the font families, all that stuff is right here. Then we have the resx folder. So this resx folder has all that resources. So if you added all the languages here, you would have different resx files here with all the languages. And you can see that is set up for all the pages that we have. You can just start translating this, start changing this the way you want, and it will all be here in those resx files. You will have localization built in. So that's there as well. All the resources, of course, the fonts, the images, although I think most images and content is loaded over the internet, so you should already have sample code for you to do that for you as well. So there isn't too much resources in here, but you can add your own, of course, if that's what you need. You have a couple of helpers, so they will have helpers for you to do some kind of things. It's mostly to support their own code, but maybe there's something useful in there that you can use as well. And we have this controls folder. So for kind of like the simple controls, which do something with styling, all the code will be here, will be included in this code. So we have emoji text. I'm not really sure what that does, but it has something to do with emojis, I guess. We have this rounded image, right? So we have an image, which is apparently rounded. So we'll take the square image border, an indicator. You can add a badge to it, apparently, and you will have the XAML and the code right here, right? So this is just included. You can tweak that if that's what you need. Of course, like, you know, you will have the more advanced controls like a video player or a map. That's things that they're developing that costs a lot of effort, so they're not giving away the source for that. But kind of like these minor, it's cool controls, it's not minor, but these minor controls that just do a little bit of styling, they will include the full source for you in here so that you can even customize that as well. So everything is included here. That is really cool. And then the main event will have all the views. They're divided up into different folders here. We'll have the articles one with the articles details, the articles feed, the demo app. So that kind of like wires up the whole app with the flyout menu and kind of like the whole shelf of things. The onboarding, so the walkthrough image path, the generic about page. So that is really cool. But if you look into this XAML page, well, again, you get the full design, of course. It's divided up into templates, which you can find here with the item templates and that kind of stuff. So it's really modular, really clean code, and that you can reuse all over the place. But you will also see that it's already wired up to the view model. So if we go into this one, you can see that it will already set the binding context for you, right? So it will do that. And it will have the on item tapped. It will have those events wired up for you already. So we also have the view models right here for the articles. Which one did I get? The articles view feed page. So we have the list view model right here. And you will have all of this right here. So the observable collection on culture change. See, so they will do the dynamic translation of stuff for you as well. Load data, so we'll have a little JSON file to load some data for you that's included. And this will help you get started building your own application. I cannot shut up about how much is included in all of this and how amazing it is that you can just get started with this. As you have probably noticed by now, I can barely contain my excitement for all of this because I think this is a really, really cool product. You can click together these crazy cool designs, pages on a website, download the code, and that lays the groundwork of your entire app. You can just use that to build upon and build your app further. I am convinced that this is a major time saver if you want to build a serious application. So definitely go look into this. Huge congrats to the Grial Kit team for launching this new major version, Grial Kit 4. And you've seen me play with this license. It's a paid product. So, you know, you might be like, I really want to use this, but I can't really afford it maybe, or maybe there's other reasons. So the Grial Kit team has been so generous to give me another 4 license, because it's Grial Kit 4, to give away on this channel. How cool is that? All that you need to do is comment under this video why you think you need this, what you're going to build with this, add a little hashtag #ILoveGrial, and I will be randomly sorting out 4 comments by October 3rd, that's a Monday. I will then do a little short video or announcement on the community page, so make sure that you're subscribed to my channel with the winners and a way to contact me, so be on the lookout for that. If you've liked this video, please click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and maybe you want to know more about .NET MAUI, then please check out this playlist, check out this recommended video, check out this button if you're subscribed already, and let me know, of course, if you want to see more about Grial Kit in the future. See you for the next one.